So this is stressing the fact that all points of inflection, dty by dx squared is zero, but not necessarily the same if you look at it from the other way around. If I start off with dty by dx squared is zero, then not necessarily points of inflection. It could be just a max or a min. Like if I had two different equations for a cubic, if I had that and that, we've got a very definite min, we've got a very definite max. If I look at that where it's just positive, zero, positive, it's not quite the same, is it? So it's looking at those differences. Okay. So there's a plan. Find where d2y by dx squared is zero. Check the value on either side of it. And if it changes, it tells us it's a point of inflection. Okay. That's our plan. So that's our game. So I've got y equals e to the x minus e to the minus x. So I'm going to differentiate it twice. So I'm going to find, so in terms of a plan, I'm going to find d2y by dx squared. I hope you can hear this all right, because I'm using the mic. It's not really picking it up the same. Just the normal mics that we use with Teams. So that's e to the x. It'll be minus minus e to the minus x. That's plus e to the minus x. And then the second differential will be e to the x minus e to the minus x. So I've found d2y by dx squared. I'm now going to solve d2y by dx squared is equal to zero. So at my point of inflection, d2y by dx squared is zero. So e to the x minus, now e to the minus x, you can see as 1 over e to the x. That makes it a little bit easier. So that's equal to zero. If I take it over, I've got e to the x is 1 over e to the x. Then if I multiply through by e to the x, I've got e to the x times by e to the x. Now remember, you add the powers if you times in, so that's e to the 2x is 1. And then if I take logs, 2x is log of 1. Remember with your log graph, the log of 1 is 0. So 2x is 0, x is 0. Right. So then, what do I know? So if x is 0, I've got e to the 0 minus e to the minus 0. So I get 0 out, don't I? So hang on a sec, I'm going to pause this. I've got myself confused. Right, so I've found where d2y by dx squared is 0. So d2y by dx squared is 0 at the point 0, 0. Now the completed pack says that that's the stationary point. It may well be, but I'm not. I want to see if there's a change in sign around that point of inflection. I think what it's supposed to say is that's a possible point of inflection. I think that's what it really should have said. Inflection. There. Right, so I need to choose numbers around it. So I need to choose x values around x is naught. So I can be quite close to it or I can be quite far away. You've got a picture of the graph. You just want to make sure that you choose a number which doesn't kind of have another point of inflection in between it. So although the pack uses x is minus 0.1, and I'm going to sub that into d2y by dx squared. So my d2y by dx squared was e to the x, so it's e to the minus 0.1 minus e to the minus minus 0.1. Stick that in your calc, you get minus 0.2 according to the pack. And then I'm going to choose the same distance away on the other side. So d2y by dx squared to the 0.1 minus e to the minus 0.1, that gives me 0.2. Right, I've got a change of sign. D2y by dx squared around, oops, my writing's atrocious, around the point 0, 0. Therefore, now because of this change in sign here, because of that, that is massively important. That makes it a point of inflection. Therefore, point. Now there is a question for you to do, so I would pause the video, have a go, and then just redo it, because I'm just going to uncover it now. So just check your answers. There. So we differentiated it twice, tick, we agree. We found where d2y by dx squared is equal to 0. Got the coordinates there. Does it ask for the coordinates? Oh yeah, find its coordinates, yeah. And then... what have they done? So we should, so that was just checking to see if it's concave or not, isn't it? So concave, concavity, and just checking. If the second differential is less than or equal to 0. So whereas here, the first example, we made sure it was a point of inflection. On this second example, we're just seeing if it's concave there. So just be clear on the differences between these questions, because the question for you, you'd hope, would just mirror. It doesn't. But never mind, it's all good. Right then. So example two, says find the coordinates of the point of inflection for this graph. Right, so find, first of all, in terms of a plan, we want d2y by dx squared. So dy by dx is 8x cubed plus 12x squared minus 144x. Differentiate it again, d2y by dx squared, 24x squared plus 24x minus 144. Right then, so we know at the point of inflection, so let's make my plan. I want d2y by dx squared is 0. We should be starting to spot this now. So d2y by dx squared is 0. So 24x squared plus 24x minus 144 is equal to 0. Bang that into poly. So 24 minus 144 gives us x is 2 or x is 3. I've got 2 points to check. So now I want to check on either side. So for x is 2, here down here, so for x is 2, I'm going to try x is 1.9, so d2y by dx squared is going to be 24, 1.9 squared, minus 144, and that's equal to minus 11.76. Now I'm running out of time for this question. I'm just going to do the others, and I'm going to pause it while I do the others so it magically appears. Right then, I've just done some extra scribbling, so let's have a look at the point 2. Oh, I must say as well, it was minus 3, not 3 there. So for x is 2, I've got a sign change, so that must be a point of inflection. And that's that. If I sub 2 into the equation, the original equation, I get minus 2. 2, 4. So that's where your point of inflection is for that one. This one here, I'm going to run out of time, aren't I? I've only got 10 seconds left. That's a sign change. It's a point of inflection. Have a go at the question. See you later. Bye.